वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, आज हम लोग मैथमेटिक्स के एक टॉपिक की बात करने वाले हैं और आज हम बात करेंगे मेंसुरेशन के बारे में। ओके, तो आज हम बात करने वाले हैं मेंसुरेशन के बारे में। मेंसुरेशन तो वी शुड नो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल व्हाट इज द पर्पज ऑफ रीडिंग और स्टडिंग मेंसुरेशन। इन मेंसुरेशन वी लर्न अबाउट पेरिमीटर एंड एरिया ऑफ सम प्लेन फिगर। ओके, सो इन दिस टॉपिक और इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल लर्न दैट व्हाट इज द एरिया और पेरिमीटर ऑफ सम प्लेन फिगर in two dimensional space. Okay, so let us start with our structure, that is triangle. We should learn about triangle. As you know students that triangle is a closed polygon formed by three straight line. Okay, so as you know that triangles are of three types. First one, we should learn scalene triangle. Okay, what is scalene triangle? Scalene triangle is a triangle in which length of all sides are different from each other. इसमें जो sides की length होती है AB, BC और CA, ये length में equal नहीं होती है। जब किसी triangle की तीनों sides length में आपस में equal नहीं होती है तो उसको हम लोग बोलते हैं scalene triangle. Okay? तो सबसे पहले हम इसके मान लो BC side की length A है और AC की B है और AB की C है. Okay students, we have considered the length of three sides that are AB and C. Now we should know what is the perimeter and area of this scalene triangle. So first of all we should learn about perimeter. Then perimeter here it is denoted by 2S. That will be sum of all sides mean A plus B plus Okay students, so in this case of scalene triangle the perimeter is sum of all the sides. Okay, now we should know about area. What is area? Here area of this triangle will be calculated using the Heron's formula, that is area of any triangle is S minus A, S minus B, S minus C. This is the area of this triangle. Okay? Where S is A plus B plus C by 2 and we have written here. S is known as semi-perimeter. A, B and C are sides of this triangle. Okay? Now we should learn about another triangle, that is isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangle. So we should know that what is isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangles are those triangles in which length of two sides are equal. Okay, length of two sides are equal. A, B and C. Here we are assuming that sides AB and AC are equal in length. So we can assume the length of AB, that is small a, and length of AC also small a, एंड लेंथ ऑफ बी सी इज बी. ओके सो व्हाट विल बी इट्स पेरिमीटर. इट्स पेरिमीटर विल बी व्हाट सम ऑफ ऑल साइड्स दैट विल बी a plus b. व्हाट इज दिस 2a plus b. सो ये पेरिमीटर इज 2a plus b. नाउ we should learn about area of this triangle. Then area equal to what? S minus A, S minus B. Because here two sides are equal in length. Okay. So this is the area of isosceles triangle. Okay, students. Now we can take its outside of square root sign, so it will be S minus A square root of S, S minus B. Okay students, now we should learn about third type of triangle, that is equilateral triangle. Third is equilateral triangle. Then what are equilateral triangles? Equilateral triangles are those type of triangles in which all sides are equal in length. Okay, so let us draw a triangle which appears equal in length. Its name is A, its name is B, and its name is C. So we should put the length of these triangles. We should assume that length of each side is small a. So first of all we should know perimeter. Then what is perimeter? Perimeter will be A plus A plus A, that is 3a. So here 2s is 3a. Okay, now we should learn about perpendicular length. Assume that it is d. So what will be ad? Ad is equal to root 3 by 2 a. Okay, ad will be root 3 by 2 a. Now what will be area? It is also known as altitude length. What will be area? Area A is equal to what? Square root 3 by 4 a square. It is the area of equilateral triangle where it denotes two sides. Okay. So students, we have learned about triangle and types of triangle with their perimeter and areas. Now we should tell about turn towards some other plane figures. Now we are assuming other plane figure, that is rectangle, square, parallelogram, rhombus and trapezium. Okay, on students, we know that area of triangle is also denoted by one formula, that is 1 by 2 base into height. What is this? 1 by 2 base into height. This is also the formula for the area of triangle. It can be also applied to any triangle in which base and heights are known. Okay. Students, we should try this question. Then we observe in this question, the three sides of any triangles are given. So let us draw a triangle that is some this that is A, B and C. One side is 26, another 28 and this is 30. Okay, in centimeter these sides are given. Now as we see here, this is an scalene triangle. So area of scalene triangle will be find out using the Heron's formula. As we know that in the Heron's formula we have requirement of four parameters that are S, A, B and C. A, B, C are length of the triangle sides and S is semi perimeter. So first of all we should assign value A equal to 26, B equal to 28 and C equal to 30. These values are in centimeter. Okay. Now we should find out semi perimeter. So semi perimeter S is equal to what we do? That will be A plus B plus C by 2. This is the value of semi perimeter. So now we should put the value of AB and C. So S, what is S? S will be 26 plus 28 plus 30 by 2. Now what will happen? Addition of these will be 30 plus 58 plus 26, 84 by 2. Now what will be this? This will be 42 centimeter. So what is the smallest? The small S is 42 centimeter. Now area, what is area? Area is square root of S, S minus A, S minus B and S minus C. So now put the value of S, S is 42. Another bracket it will be 42 minus 26, it is 42 minus 28 and it is 42 minus 30. Okay, now simplify this, it is 42 minus 26 will be this will be 42 minus 26 will be 16. And it will be 14 and it will be 10. Now we should arrange this term and to find out the square root. After simplifying this we get 336 centimeter square. We can write this square centimeter also. So we have calculated the area of the given triangles as per data and that is 336 cm square. Hence we have calculated the area of an scalene triangle using the Heron's formula. Now we should look towards another question, that is area of right angle triangle is question is area of right angle triangle is area of right angle triangle is 42 square centimeter. If its perpendicular is equal to 10 centimeters, then find its base. Okay, students. as per given in data, we have a right angle triangle. So let us draw the right angle triangle that is A, B and C. Okay. Its area is given 33 square centimeter. Perpendicular is 10 centimeter. We have to find out base length. Length of base is x centimeter. Okay. So as per given in the data, given what is given area of triangle into 42 square centimeter. Okay. So what we have been already the formula of right angle triangle? It is 1/2 base into height. 22. Now we should put the values. Base value is x and height value is 10. So what will this? This is 2 × 5 = 10. X will be 42/5 cm. Okay students. So it is the value of our base. Now we should take another question, that is let find the length of the altitude of an equilateral triangle. Find the length of an equilateral triangle of side 6√3 cm. If it's in this question, we have to find out length of altitude. What is altitude? Altitude means any length which is started from the vertex to the opposite sides of any triangle. So first of all, we should draw our equilateral triangle. Now draw an altitude. This is altitude. This AD is known as altitude. Okay. As in the introduction part of triangle, we have already discussed the altitude of triangle, and we know that altitude of equilateral triangle equal to what? √3/2a. √3/2a is altitude of an equilateral triangle. So √3/2a is equal to what will be this? This will be 6√3. Okay. √3 will be cancelled out. Here will be a/2 equal to 6. What will be a equal to 6/2? That is a equal to 10 cm. Okay, friends. Sorry, friends. This is not altitude. We have to find out altitude. So altitude is √3/2a. That will be equal to √3/2 × 6√3, because side is 6√3. As per question, this is side. This is not altitude. Okay. So what will be altitude? That will be √3/2 and 2 × 3 = 6 into √3 × √3. What will be? This will be 3 × 3. That will be 9 cm. Okay, friends. So So length of altitude will be length of altitude equal to 9 cm. In previous calculation we have considered this as altitudes. If altitude is this, then in question there will be to find out length of equilateral triangle. So on the basis of previous calculation we can calculate the length of sides. Okay students, now we should discuss another question. Okay. Okay, students. Question is, here question is, the perimeter of an isosceles triangle is isosceles triangle is 32 cm. While its equal sides, together measure is 18 cm. Find the third side. And the chap equal side. Okay, let us draw a triangle that is isosceles. So let us, these sides are A and this is isosceles triangle. So we have considered two sides, small A and small A. Okay, now what will happen? Consider this side is small A. So we know that perimeter of a triangle is sum of all sides. Perimeter, what will be perimeter? That is a plus b, that will be 2a plus b. 2a plus b is perimeter. So 2a plus b equal to 32 as per given in the question. Okay, while its equal size together measure is 18 cm. Means if you measure these two sides, then combined length of these two equal sides are 18 cm. That will mean according to given condition a plus a equal to 18, then 2a equal to 18. What will be a 18 by 2? That will be 9 cm. So we have got each of equal sides 9 cm. Now we can put value of A in equation number 1. Put A in equation 1. What will happen? It will be 2 into 9 plus B equal to 32. 18 plus B equal to 32. What will be B equal to 32 minus 18? B will be, this is 14 cm. So find the third side and each equal sides. So what is B? B is 14 cm. Okay students, this is third side and each of equal sides are 9 cm. These are 9 cm. So we have calculated the answer of this question. In this question we have given the perimeter and two sides are equal and also we have given the combined measure of two equal sides. So on the basis of conditions given in the problem we have calculated the question easily. Okay. Now we should discuss another plane figures that are quadrilateral. Okay. Now we should discuss quadrilateral. So our next topic is quadrilateral. Okay, students. What is quadrilateral? Any plane figure or any polygon formed by four sides. Any polygon formed by four sides is known as quadrilateral. Means, if we make something this is a polygon. And formed by four sides, that's are AB, BC, CA, AB, BC, CD and AD. These are four sides from which this quadrilateral is formed. Okay, students. Now we should discuss some types of quadrilateral. So let us discuss first. Parallelogram. What is parallelogram? Parallelogram is a quadrilateral in which pair of opposite sides are parallel to each other. If we draw a figure in which its name are here, AB is parallel to CD, BC is parallel to AD. Okay, friends, AB is parallel to CD and BC is parallel to AD. Okay, this is a quadrilateral. This quadrilateral is parallelogram if AB parallel to CD and BC parallel to AD. This is the basic requirement of parallelogram. On the basis of these conditions, we have calculated more results that in a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal also. In a parallelogram, the diagonals bisects each other, and in parallelogram, the sum of our opposite angles are equal, right? A equal to C. We can say that A equal to C, B equal to D, and parallelogram sum of two consecutive angles is 180 degrees. All these conclusions are formed on the basis of this basic definition of parallelogram. So now let us discuss the area of parallelogram. So we should discuss area of parallelogram. We have parallelogram. B denotes parallelogram. This is parallelogram. ABCD. Now we have to find out its area. Its area will be what? Something base into height. Area of parallelogram is what? Base into height. In this question, we should consider that AB is base and its height is h. So, area of parallelogram ABCD equal to base is AB and height is h. Okay, students. Now, we should take another plane figure that is rhombus. We should take now rhombus and we have to calculate area and other thing of rhombus. Rhombus. Okay, first of all, this is known as Parting Rhombus. Rhombus is a parallelogram in which all of the four sides are equal in length. Okay, this is rhombus A, B, C, D, in which all length of all sides will be equal. Means AB equal to BC equal to CD is equal to DA. Now, what will happen? Let us consider its diameter is diagonal is length is its length is D1 and length of another diagonal is D2. So now we have to find out area of the rhombus. So area of rhombus ABCD, what will be area is? Its area is 1 by 2 divided into D2 means multiply the diagonal length and divide that by 2. This will give the area of rhombus. Okay, there are some important properties also of rhombus that in a rhombus the diagonal bisects each other at right angle. Means these angles will be 90 degree. Okay, these angles will be 90 degree. So we can say that in a rhombus the diagonals bisect each other at 90 degree. Okay friends, now we should discuss another figure that is rectangle. What will the perimeter of rhombus? That will be sum of all sides, that is 4 into 1 side. Okay, now we should know that what is rectangle. Rectangle is some any parallelogram in which opposite sides are parallel and equal and the measure of each angle is 90 degree. Means if it is our rectangle, then we can say that AB, CD, we can say that AB and CD are parallel and equal. Similarly, BC and AD are parallel and equal. And in this, the measure of each angle is 90 degree. Okay, students. So in rectangle, AB equal to CD and BC equal to AD and angle A equal to angle B equal to angle C equal to angle D is equal to 90 degree. Okay, students. So we have calculated some angles of rectangle and there are some properties also of rectangle. That in a rectangle, the length of diagonals are equal and diagonal bisect each other and some other properties which follow the Pythagoras theorem can be applied here. Okay, now we should discuss another clear figure that is square. We should discuss square. What is square? Okay, what is square? Any plane figure or any parallelogram in which all four sides are equal in length. Now we should discuss also area. This area will be what? Something AB into CB. Okay, length into breadth. We are discussing the square. In square, the length of all sides are equal and the measure of all angles, measure of each angle is 90 degree. A equal to angle B, equal to angle C, equal to angle D, and each will be 90 degree. Okay, students. Thus, we have studied the some our quadrilaterals, parallelogram, rhombus, rectangles, square, and their areas. Okay, now we should discuss area of this square. Its area will be side square, that is area square. Okay, we can take square of any side because every sides are equal in length. Okay, friend. Now we should discuss another coordinator, that is rhombus. Trapezium. Now we should discuss trapezium. Trapezium is a polyhedron in which the one pair of opposite sides are parallel to each other. If it is trapezium, then pair of opposite sides are parallel. Means we can say that AB parallel CB. This pair of opposite sides are parallel. Okay, friends. In the trapezium, we know another name, that is isosceles trapezium. If any trapezium is isosceles, then their non-parallel sides will be equal. So for isosceles trapezium, what will be the condition? Condition will be AB parallel CD and also BC equal to AD. Okay, friends. This is okay. So we have discussed the quadrilaterals, their properties, and also we should discuss the area of trapezium. So its area will be area. What is area? Let us length of this side is a small a, length of this side is small b, and distance between their parallel sides is h. So what will be the area of this trapezium? Its area a will be 1/2 sum of parallel sides. Sum of A plus B and distance between parallel sides, that is H. Okay, friends. So it is the area of trapezium. Okay, friends. Now we have discussed quadrilaterals and their types and as well as their areas. Okay, friends. In the next lecture, we will discuss some problems related to quadrilaterals. Okay, thank you.